plugging into the grid, basically. They have no rare earth minerals, and there's also ways of storing that power now in salt rather than having to deal with batteries and the non-recyclability and all that, all the stuff that comes with that. But there's, you do have to do a little bit, be a little bit of a detective. And in a way, it's kind of fun, but you just, I think if you focus on what you love, and focus on, on your sense of, ethics, and think about the whole cycle. Like, I know a lot of people who are saying, I'm making ethical clothing, and, we're using organic cotton. Well, that's great, but still, it takes 9 years of drinking water to make the cotton, just to grow the cotton for one t-shirt. And that's not even the dyeing or the processing. So, when we we think of these things as disposable. Oh, I don't know why I'm saying we're going to get another t-shirt. It's 9 years of drinking water. So is that really ethical still? It's organic. Yeah, better than spraying everything with, all kinds of poisons and getting it into the water tables and everything. But, so there's information out there about everything, and you just need to really try to think about the big picture, obviously, fair trade, anything that's fair trade is more likely not to have had slave labor. It's not 100% guaranteed that slave labor or sweatshops weren't involved, but it is more likely that things aren't fair trade. There's an incredible man out of Mexico named Eugenio Gras, who is starting a revolution amongst farmers and teaching them how to make biofertilizers and their own fungicides and pesticides and things with stuff they can find on their farm that's not toxic, that's free. Definitely study permaculture, biodynamics. Okay. Yes, sir.